मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू टॉपिक इन इंग्लिश ग्रामर, एडजेक्टिव्स, एंड वी विल स्टडी कंपैरिजन इन दिस चैप्टर. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू नो व्हाट आर एडजेक्टिव्स.
यस मैम.
ओके, सो प्रखर, टेल मी व्हाट इज एन एडजेक्टिव.
मैम, अ वर्ड दैट टेल्स मोर अबाउट अ नाउन इज कॉल्ड एडजेक्टिव्स.
Only a noun?
Ma'am, pronoun also.
Okay, pronoun also. So, a word which describes a noun or a pronoun or adds something more to the meaning of a noun or a pronoun is called an adjective. Okay, I think you also must have studied about the degrees of adjective. Yes,
yes, ma'am.
How many degrees yes, of adjectives are there?
Ma'am, three.
Okay, three. What is the first one?
Ma'am, positive.
Comparative.
Ma'am, positive, comparative, superlative.
Okay, so positive, comparative and superlative. Now, adjective in its base form, alright, is said to be in positive degree when it is used to simply describe a noun or a pronoun or to make similar comparisons with other similar nouns. Like for example, Hari is a tall boy, so we are simply describing a noun. Which noun are we describing here?
Positive.
Hari is a tall boy. Okay, in this sentence, the word tall is used to describe which noun?
Ma'am, Hari.
Yes, Hari. Yes,
sir.
Hari is what type of a boy?
Ma'am, proper noun. Ma'am, tall boy.
Hari is what type of a boy?
Tall boy.
So it is describing boy. Alright. Hari is what type of a boy? He is a tall boy. So an adjective is said to be in its positive form if it is used only to describe a noun or a pronoun, or sometimes even to make comparisons with similar nouns, like with a boy only, like Hari is as tall as Mohan. So, positive degree is normally used to describe a noun and sometimes also used to make comparisons. Then we have the comparative degree. Yes. What is a comparative degree?
Ma'am, when we compare,
when we compare among how many?
Number two.
All right. So when we show comparison between two nouns, then we use the comparative form. Okay? Like, see the example here. If Hari is 6 feet tall and Harry is 6 feet and 1 inch tall, then obviously what does it mean? That both are tall. But what it means is that Harry is taller than Hari. Okay, now third degree, superlative. Yes,
ma'am, it is compared.
It is compared with many people.
Yes, one of you say yes, Iram.
Ma'am, when it is compared with two or more things or two or more person.
Okay, more than two?
Between, among a group of people.
Yes,
ma'am.
Among a whole group or a whole class of people. So, then we use superlative. Okay. Then, see, like we have done this example that Hari is 6 feet tall and Harry is 6 feet 1 inches tall. So, both are tall, but who is taller? Harry is taller than Hari. Now, if in this above example, there is also a third boy, Hamid. And this Hamid is taller than both Hari as well as Harry. Page number 32. Both Hari and Harry. Then what we can say is that among this group of three boys, Hamid is the tallest. So tallest is thus the superlative form of tall. Okay. Now, how to form comparative and superlative forms? Now, there are some rules which we follow to form the comparative and superlative degrees of adjectives. Now, the first and the easiest is by adding the suffixes er or est. Er to comparative and est to the
superlative.
When we add est, we form the superlative. Okay,
superlative.
Now this method by adding er or est to the positive degree, now this method is normally used for one syllable and two syllable adjectives. Now what is this syllable? Now syllable is basically a unit of pronunciation, a unit of pronouncing, a unit of pronunciation having one vowel sound. Okay, so one syllable will mean one vowel sound. Here we are not saying vowels. Okay, don't get confused that if there are two, three vowels, then it will surely be a three syllable word. No, it is not like that. I will tell you just now, I will explain it to you. So one syllable, two syllable, basically what is a syllable? It is a unit of pronunciation in which we have one vowel sound, alright? And now, for example, the word cat. Cat. How many vowel sounds you have? We have just one vowel here. We have just one vowel here. And that vowel sound only that we have here is cat. Cat. Alright, that a sound. So, here we have, this is a, or you can say cat is a one syllable word. Now if we look at the word power, p-o-w-e-r, okay, power, or if you break it power, how many syllable sounds, how many
o
vowels,
and
sorry,
e.
How many vowel sounds are there?
O and E, two.
All right,
o
two vowel sounds we have, so that would be a two syllable word. So par is a two syllable word, just like cat, short, they are one syllable words. Par is power. All right, so it is a two syllable word because we have two vowel sounds. Now if we have a look at the word happy, happy, what do you think, how many syllable word is happy? I am talking about not vowels, I am talking about vowel sound. Happy. How many vowel sounds?
Two.
Yes, two vowel sounds. Now, you know what happens in this form? Why? Because it makes a sound like a vowel. So, that is also considered as making a vowel sound. Happy, P. It is making a what sound? E sound, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
All
yes,
right.
Ma'am.
So,
yes,
happy
ma'am.
Will be a two syllable word. Now, if we have a look at the word beautiful. If you see how many vowels are there, just not the sounds, the vowels. How many vowels are there in this word?
Ma'am, three.
Ma'am, four. How many? B, E, A, U, then I, then again U. How many vowels you have?
Ma'am, five. Three.
Five.
Ma'am, five.
We have five vowels. But we don't have so many vowel sounds in the word beautiful. Now the first B, E, A, U, we pronounce as bu. So it is making only one vowel sound. It is not making three vowel sounds. B-A-U. We don't pronounce it like that, do we? No. We pronounce it like bu. So, one vowel sound is bu, then te, T-I, and full. So, beautiful is a three syllable word. Understood this much?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, for one syllable and two syllable adjectives, normally what we do? We add er or est, and now there are different ways of adding the suffix. Now, this depends upon the spelling of the positive adjective. Now, see. Now, if the positive adjective, it ends in two consonants. When it is ending in two consonants. Like, see, for example, here, short or high. The last two alphabets, RT, there are consonants. GH, there are consonants. Right? You all know what are vowels and consonants?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. So, if the positive, it ends in two consonants, then, and if the second consonant is not a Y, all right, then what happens? Then the suffixes ER and EST are added to the positive, like short, shorter, shortest, high, higher, highest, okay? Then, so second consonant, if the positive end ends in two consonants and the second is not a Y, then or if there is a single consonant at the end and before that we had a long vowel sound. Bird. Bird. If we say bird, it is making a short vowel sound. But if we say C, C, so C is making a long vowel sound. So it depends on that also. So if the positive adjective, it ends in a single consonant and before that we had a long vowel, then also we make their comparative and superlative by adding ER or EST, like clever or great. Then if the positive, it ends in two consonants and the second is a Y, then what we do? We drop the Y and we add IER or IEST, like happy, hungry, all right, or sunny, lovely. What we do? It has two consonants at the end and the last one is Y. So what we do? We will leave the Y, we will drop the Y and we will add IER or IEST to make its comparative and superlative form. Okay. Now, if the positive, it ends in a single consonant and before that single consonant, we have a short vowel. We don't have a long vowel, we have a short vowel, all right? Then what happens? The last consonant, we double it and then we add ER or EST, like big, thin. So what we do? We just double the last consonant here and then we add ER or EST to make the comparative and the superlative. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Excuse
then,
me, ma'am.
See the last one here. If the positive...
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Iram?
Ma'am, I have not understood the second one.
Which one? It ends in two consonants. The last one is a Y. That one?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, see the first one. It had two consonants and the second was not a Y. Then what we will do? We will simply add ER and EST to make its comparative and superlative. But if the positive, it ends in two consonants and the last consonant is a Y. Alright? So, just you have to see whether the word has two consonants at the end or not. And if it is having two consonants at the end and the last one is Y. So, what we do? We leave the Y. We drop the Y. And we add IER or IEST to form the comparative and the superlative. Then, if the positive, it ends in single consonant and before that single consonant, we have a short vowel, not a long one. And then what we do? We just double the last consonant and add ER or EST, like big, bigger, biggest, thin, thinner, thinnest. Okay? And one more. Now, if the positive or the adjective, it is ending in E, then what we do? We simply add R and ST because it is already ending in E. So, there is no need to add one more E. So, if the positive, it ends in E, then what we do? we add simply R and ST to make its comparative and superlative. Alright, now there is one more way in which we make the comparative and superlative, and that is by adding more or less or most or least to form the comparative and the superlative degree. Now this method is used mostly for most of the two syllable and all adjectives of more than two syllables. So if any adjective will have more than two syllable, so three and more, we normally use this rule only by adding more or most. All right, more interesting, most interesting, more beautiful, most beautiful. Like I told you, the word beautiful, how many syllables it had? It has three syllables. So what will happen when an adjective, it will have more than two syllables, and also for most of the two syllable also we use this type only, this rule only, by adding more or most before the word. Like for example, so now what happened, now if we are making a upward comparison, means in higher degree, then what we say, we will say if you are making an upward comparison, so we say more comfortable, most comfortable. But if we are making comparison in downward, or we are making a downward comparison, then we say less comfortable or least comfortable. All right, so in this way we can make both the upward comparison also as well as the downward comparison. Okay, like difficult, more difficult, most difficult, less difficult, least difficult. Alright, interesting, more interesting, most interesting. Or if we do the downward conversion, then it will be less interesting and least interesting. Okay, now then there are certain words which form their comparative and superlative. They do not as such follow any rule, and it is by irregular construction, means not by the rules which we have done till now, and they are irregular. Like, you know, bad, worse, worst, good, better, best. So obviously, you know, we are changing the whole words here. So sometimes the comparatives are also formed by irregular method, means we do not follow any regular construction or any regular rules, but their comparatives and superlatives are formed just like that. Like good, better, best, bad, worse, worst, little, less, least, all right? Much more most, or many more most, like that. Okay, now let's try to do exercise A. Turn your books to exercise A on page 35. What we have to do in this exercise, we have to fill in the blanks with the correct form of adjectives which are given in the brackets. So in the brackets we have already been given the adjective, we just have to use the correct adjective. So if it is only describing a noun, then we'll have to use a positive degree. If there is comparison between two things of a same kind, then we will use comparative, or if it is more than two, then obviously we'll use the superlative degree. And at some places you'll also have to add the appropriate articles. So if in these sentences you feel that some article is missing, so that also you have to add. Okay, first one. Mridula has a dash room than her sister.
Tidier.
T-I-D-I-E-R. Because see, the last, it is ending, the positive has two consonants at the end and the last consonant is Y. So we drop the Y and we add I-E-R for comparative and I-E-S-T for the superlative. Australia is dash than England.
Bigger.
Serena is a dash tennis player than Venus. Savita got dash friends than you, but that doesn't matter.
fever.
F-E-W-E-R. F-E-W-E-R. Fewer. Quite a people think that Japanese is dash language to learn.
Are difficult.
Quite a few people think that Japanese is a difficult language to learn. That is okay, correct, no problem. Or you can even write the most difficult, even that would be correct. So either write a difficult, or there could also be one more case where you could use the most difficult. The Mohun Bagan Football Club played dash than the East Bengal Football Club yesterday.
Worse.
This comparative degree, worse. Cats are not dash than dogs.
More intelligent.
Correct. Trigonometry is dash than geometry.
More difficult.
Okay. Dash desert of all is the Sahara and it's in Africa.
The hottest.
Before the superlative, we use the article the. So the. The hottest desert of all is the Sahara. Last, who is dash person in your family?
The most talkative.
Next exercise. Complete the following sentences with the appropriate degree of comparison. And here also you have to use appropriate articles wherever there are required. A bicycle is... Yes?
Ma'am, can you please repeat the
eighth one, trigonometry? Difficult.
Okay. Ma'am, tenth one.
The most talkative. Alright, exercise B. Yes, which one?
Ma'am, seventh one.
Okay, seventh is more intelligent. Alright, exercise B. A bicycle is dash than a motorbike.
I'm cheaper.
A river is dash than a canal.
Broader.
A bicycle is dash means of transport in a traffic jam.
The most convenient.
Correct. The most convenient. Gold is dash than silver.
More expensive.
Okay. Cherrapunji averages dash rainfall in India.
The highest.
Right, correct. The highest. A hyena is dash than a tiger.
More ferocious.
A hyena is more ferocious than a tiger. Priyanka is dash girl in her class.
I'm the laziest.
Priyanka is the laziest girl in her class. India is a dash country than Pakistan.
I'm larger.
Okay. Monica is dash at academics than any other girl in the academy.
Monica is better at academics than any other girl in the academy.
And the last one here, a car usually goes dash than a bus.
Faster.
Now see this last exercise, exercise C. Now that is your homework. I think this you will be able to do by yourself. You can fill this positive, comparative and superlative table. You will be able to do this?
Yes, ma'am.
Alright. Okay, so this will be your homework for today.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, what we have to do in the copy?
Yes, beta?
Ma'am, what we have to do in the copy?
In the copy? You can do the third exercise. Make the table in your copy.
Okay, ma'am. Excuse me, ma'am.
All right.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Excuse me, ma'am.
So that would be all for today.